Good morning. My name is Andrew Huynh, here with SBTN DC, and today we have the opportunity to talk with Tam Trinh about her experiences here at SBTN Youth and Media Program. Good morning, Tam.
Morning, Andrew.
So, Tam, tell us a little bit more about your experiences and about what you did here at SBTN DC.
Well, what I did here was they basically taught me how to broadcast and make the news from beginning to end. Taught me how to handle the cameras and do taping. They also taught me how to edit videos and also how to export it and air it online on the TV. And one of the other things I learned is to interview people and to actually just go and report on things. So it was basically from like the beginning to the end of the news. So I mean, that was great.
Okay. Can you tell us a little bit more about your interviews? How'd it go? Were you nervous?
Yes, actually, at my very first interview, I was very, very nervous. I came in, it was actually quite a surprise. I didn't know that I was going to be interviewing that day. So I came in, the person that I interviewed was Miss Julie Koo, the director of Asian American Pacific Islander Affairs. It's quite a mouthful, as you can see. So the first day I was so nervous, my throat just closed up. I couldn't say her title right, and she had to introduce herself. But I think I've improved a little bit since then. At least I can say people's titles now. And I guess just going to events and interviewing people, it's helped me interact with a lot of different people, helped me with my communication and social skills. And it's also, I guess it's taught me to interact with more people and especially leaders in the community. And it just taught me like the importance of the community and leadership. And I guess just talking to them and learning about what they do, it just shows me that it's important just to stay more involved.
Who else did you interview?
I also interviewed Mr. Shannon Fan and Lieutenant Commander Chris Fan.
So it sounds like you got to meet with a lot of the leaders in the Vietnamese community. Tell us more about your experience just with the Vietnamese community and what you learned and your news perspective.
Well, I guess this really gave me a more in-depth perspective in the Vietnamese community. It taught me that even though like we're Vietnamese Americans and that people have been here for like decades, they still don't forget that they're Vietnamese. That's still a very important part of who they are, and they try to keep that part of them alive. People come in here and give the news and talk about Vietnamese culture and events, and they're like more than willing to share that and just try to keep our culture alive and our language. And I think I've always taken that for granted. And now it's like, it's a great gift of being Vietnamese and just learning that the community can come together and people try to keep this, like, we can easily forget that we're Vietnamese and we can try to assimilate into the American community. But these people not only assimilate, but they also strengthen themselves by keeping the Vietnamese community alive and trying to keep it strong and not forgetting. And I think that's a really important part.
So you've gained this new perspective on the Vietnamese community. Like, from what you've seen, are there any issues in the Vietnamese community?
With the Vietnamese community, I think that sometimes our Vietnamese community could be a little bit isolated from other Asian communities. I think that we could interact with more other Asian communities. Like, we could attend more of the Korean, Chinese events just to learn more about them. And in return, I feel like they'd be more interested in us. It'll just be good communications between the different Asian communities. I think that would strengthen all of our communities as a whole. And another issue, I think, is the Vietnamese youths. How I said, we can easily forget that we're Vietnamese. And I think that it's important to remind the youths that we are Vietnamese and that it's a gift to be Vietnamese, that you know, it's an extra thing that we have. And I think that it's important to tell the youths that, you know, you should try to like learn more about Vietnamese, more about the language, more about the culture. It's definitely going to help you in the future.
So you said you had an experience with media. Can you tell us more about what you learned and your new experience and new perspectives on media?
Well, I guess I haven't had too much experience with the media, but in elementary school and middle school, we did have a school news show, and I was on that for a while. So that's why I decided to join SBTN DC. I thought it would be fun, and it definitely has been fun. But this, just being a little bit more grown up, it's taught me about it in a more serious perspective. I've learned about how important it is, and actually here, instead of talking about news, like school news and school sports, we're talking about like real media and real issues that are affecting a lot of people. So it's definitely made the news much more serious and much more important.
Okay. So on a lighter note, what are one of your favorite events as a field reporter?
Well, I guess my favorite thing to do here would be field reporting, just going to different events, and I guess just going to different events and learning about it, and then getting to share it with other people. And this isn't just, you know, sharing it with one person, with my parents, with my family. I get to share it on TV with a lot of people watching. So in a way, that makes me feel like it makes my job feel important. It makes it seem like there's a purpose to what I do. So I really like doing that. As for the favorite event, I guess one of my favorite event would be the one day we went to DC to tape the museum in Capitol Hill. You know, that's always, I like to travel and tour. So, you know, just to be able to share part of me on TV, I thought that was great.
And what was one of your favorite parts about being part of SBTN DC?
My favorite part about being SBTN DC would definitely be the learning experience and the people, I guess. First of all, the learning experience was great because I'm not a very technical person, so it was kind of difficult for me, or at least I was kind of afraid to handle the cameras and do video editings. But after a while, they taught me, and they were really patient with me, so I got the hang of it. And the other part, I think, would be the people, because I think that the people always make the place, and they always make the atmosphere, and that's what makes, you know, your time there. And the people at SBTN has been really nice to me. They've been really patient. They've been very generous with their knowledge, just telling me what to do. And not just telling me what they want me to do, but letting me experience it and like try it out for myself. Like, it's very hands-on. And that's, I think, is one of the best ways you can learn. And they actually trusted me to do that.
What, before you came into the program, were you how involved were you in the Vietnamese community? Did you watch SBTN DC or?
Involved in the Vietnamese community. My parents had SBTN running pretty much like all day, every day. But as for the involvement, I wasn't very involved in the Vietnamese community. I speak it. I'm proud of who I am. But I did not know that there were so many events for Vietnamese people to actually come together. I'm in VSA, which is in college, like Vietnamese Student Association. But at the same time, I'm not involved in anything that would propel the Vietnamese community. And I think that being here, I learned that there are so many chances for us to just be a strong community and share our heritage with other people. And I think definitely in the future, I'd take advantage of that.
So are there any last things you'd like to say?
Actually, yes. I think that I will miss this place a lot. And I guess just coming here and being a part of this, it's taught me, I guess it's just given me like a purpose and kind of like an importance, and it's taught me so much, and I'm gonna miss it. I will just miss it a lot, and I will miss the people here a lot, and I'm definitely gonna try to take the knowledge that I've learned and try to, I guess, be more a part of the media and part of the community more in the future. And I just wanna say thank you to everyone at SBTN and also everyone at home watching. That thanks for allowing me to be on here, you know, just being patient with me too.
Well, it's been really great having you here, so thank you. Thank you, Tam.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the show. I'm Andrew Huynh, and I'll see you next time.